So hello everyone, and welcome to this Moodle Academy webinar, where we will go through the designing and the development of Moodle lessons. I am Anna Kassa. I'm an education advisor here at Moodle HQ, and with me in the support today is Richard Lefroy, our learning and media technologist. And later on, we will have Jessica Crump, our Moodle community manager. Today, in today's webinar, we are going to discuss what a branching scenario is, what is Moodle lesson activity, and we are going to see in live demo how to design branching scenarios and how to develop this scenario in a Moodle lesson activity. So let's start by defining what is a branching scenario. A quick search on branching scenario would return a number of results. One definition I like a lot is from Snegirev's article, Branching Scenarios, What You Need to Know. And it goes as follows. Branching scenario is an interactive form of learning. It challenges the learner, requires them to make a decision, and then presents the consequences. Each consequence produces new challenges and more choices. And I have underlined here some keywords for the branching scenarios. You see, interactive challenges, decisions, consequences, new challenges, and more choices. And this work makes branching scenarios that important, so it's worth dedicating a whole webinar to them. So specifically, branching scenarios are known for improving engagement as they are means of active learning. They help learners learn since they give them the ability to learn from mistakes and retake. And they create a risk-free practice environment as they can simulate real-life scenarios. They also support personalized learning as each branch is basically a different learning path. And of course, it's a way to gamify a learning object since it incorporates challenges and choices. Branch scenarios are usually created using specialized authoring tools that allow the creation of interactive learning experience. Some of these are the open source software like the GLO Maker and Zette. But there are also other sophisticated and proprietary software like Articulate Storyline, Adobe Captivate, iSpring Suite, and more. These authoring tools are used independently of Moodle, but they can export the branching scenarios in a format that can be uploaded into Moodle, usually as SCORM packages. But Moodle has its own internal authoring tools for branch scenarios. And these are the lesson activity and the H5P branching scenario. Now, as we already have said, today we will focus on lessons. So before moving on, I would like your inputs. Do you like branching scenarios? Please let us know in the chat. Either as learners, either as teachers, have you experienced them?
I might just jump in really quickly, Anna. I'm sure a lot of you will remember the Choose Your Own Adventure books that we all had as a kid, and I used to love sitting down and reading those cover to cover and back to front, and you know, many times over, which is I guess, well, certainly for me, that was the introduction to these sorts of branching scenarios. So whenever I think of a lesson activity in Moodle, I'm always going back to, sitting around with a choose your own adventure book when I was 7 or 8 years old, whenever it was.
It's still exciting, isn't it? Interesting to see different options. what people say in the chat. I think we have some inputs.
Yeah, thanks for dropping your messages into the chat. So I use branching scenarios for very specific things such as network storytelling. Not in general, I prefer books in most cases. So yeah, that was my experience back in the day as well. Really like the potential I offer, but I've never actually gotten around to using one. That's from Carl. So yeah, hopefully after today, Carl, you'll potentially be a little bit inspired to try a lesson. Let's see, what else have we got? I haven't experienced them, but I would like to try to make more use of them in the future. I know that they are used in particular disciplines, e.g. medical education, for virtual patients and so on. And Satara is also a fan of choose your own adventure books, apparently.
Interesting cases indeed, in health and also in customer support services. These are very, very, very common. So thank you so much for your inputs. Let's move on a little bit and see what the Moodle lesson is. Well, a Moodle lesson is a type of activity which allows instructors to create interactive, multi-page learning objects for the students. Now, a lesson as a plugin is one of the oldest Moodle activities. Yet, I'm not sure that it is among the most popular ones, since its development is considered a bit complicated. Let me show you what I mean. In plain English, a lesson is just a sequence of pages. These pages may be content pages or questions. And so far, things look quite simple. But things in branch scenarios and branch lessons become complicated when the jumps are involved. Jumps take the student from one page to the other and define the learning path that someone will follow. To be accurate, though, the jumps is not a case of the lesson. It's a case of the branch scenario itself, and that's where the complexity comes. So, for example, if someone, in this messy example that we have here, someone may start from content one, continue to question one, then take content two and get question two. But someone else may go from question one to question two, from content one to content two, skipping all the questions, or from content one to question one, and then question two, going directly from question to question for those who think that they already know everything and don't have something to learn more, and so on. The difficult part is to conceive these paths and keep them meaningful. But as I said, this is a matter of design rather than of development. And these three ingredients, the content pages, the questions, and the jumps, are the primarily ingredients of the branching scenarios. And they are not affected by the authoring tools used. So please let us know. Have you tried Moodle Lesson before? Richard, have you? Let's start from you. Until everybody else.
I have. In fact, in my last role working at a university here in Perth, I remember we used to. You've mentioned already, it is more of a complex activity, and we used to have these drop-in sessions where staff would, people would come in and build these lessons. And I remember helping one person in particular who would bring big reams of butcher's paper in to play, like you saw before in your last slide, when you get the complex paths. So they would actually write it all out on paper and then literally piece it together on a table And they actually really enjoyed that. And I think we all got a little bit of a kick as well out of helping her put that together. And she ended up using those lessons that she created for quite a number of years and sort of refining them as she went.
And what other people say in the chat?
We've got a lot of activity in the chat here. So I'm just scrolling up to see what I have and haven't seen yet. One of the earlier comments here, the key in branching scenarios is to use choices that have real consequences, not simply guide the learners around. Certainly, I guess real consequences being, you know, you will either, well, and if we go back to our, you know, choose your own adventure book, you'll either fall into a pit of lava or you'll, you know, drop the drawbridge down and carry on. That's a good point. Claire's saying that she hasn't used lessons, but used books and embedded all the content in there. One of the, I guess, differences between books and a lesson is exactly that branching option. Books will be very, very linear. Certainly you can get the same or some of the same functionality in a book, but certainly when it comes to that branching, the lesson is going to offer something that the book, Moodle book won't. Jill is saying that she usually gets completely lost trying to set things up. So again, that's a
yep.
It's not.
Let's see after this session.
A few other people saying they've sort of touched on them a little bit. Rob says yes, but he gave up. Go on.
I can imagine the spaghetti result that lessons jumps can have, you know, all that messy thing. Should we move on? Are there more messages in the chat?
Just one more. Lessons are also great for introductions and manuals where you want to make sure that everybody has all the required information. You can check with questions and force them to review the key information. So.
I think someone is reading my mind. Because
that's the exact things that you're about to go on and talk about, aren't they?
It's exactly the example that I'm going to talk about. But soon enough, should we move on?
Let's move on, Anna.
Okay, thank you. So before going to the practical and demo stuff, I would... like to justify why lessons. Well, obviously, lesson is my favorite one, so this is the main reason for doing this webinar. But I have here a list of 8 reasons that might make lesson your favorite too. First of all, lesson is a Moodle core plugin, so it's stable and secure, and it follows the Moodle release cycles, so that's perfect. It is accessible as it is mobile friendly and it supports multimedia. It provides teachers with an extra level of personalization as it allows user and group overrides. And for example, a teacher can give extra attempts to specific learner with learning difficulty, for example, or extend the end date for a group of learners that faced a natural disaster or whatever. A lesson supports grading, reports, tracking, allowing user to continue from where they left, and activity completion, of course. It has several question types and import the questions feature for bulk question upload. And the question types supported are multi-choice, essay, matching, numerical, short answer, true-false. It has the cluster feature that allows teachers setting up a set of questions that will be randomly presented to the user. And it's a good tool for gamification, since despite the options to choose alternative paths and take challenges, which are defined by design, it also has a progress bar, and it connects with the activity results block as a leaderboard. So we have multiple elements of gamification. But above all, it's easy to update. It doesn't require an external tool, and this makes it easy for anyone to make ad hoc updates directly into the course. This might sound not that important, but in real life scenarios, in real life environments, actually, this is essential. Branching lessons are used heavily in corporate environments, and usually they are designed by specialized instructional designers and developers. So these guys work and develop a learning object, a branching scenario outside Moodle. And then they pass it over to the teacher, he uploads it. And when a small change, when the need for a small change occurs, the teacher needs to send a request to the instructional designers and the developers, make the update, and the update might be something really minor, you know, like a comma, a wrong URL, or the name of the CEO of the company that has changed. And then they have to make an update outside Moodle and then send it back the file to re-upload it into Moodle. And this can take weeks in real life, and it's really painful process. If you use Moodle Lesson, though, you can still have experts to build and make the design and the development of the lesson, the initial design and development. But ad hoc changes are very easy, so minor mistakes can be fixed by anyone that has editing rights. So that's why I like it a lot. Now, today we are going to simplify as much as possible the designing and the development process of a branching lesson activity, breaking it up into two levels. The design of branching scenario and the development of that scenario. Let's see the design process of a branching scenario first. Starting, of course, with the designing basics. A branching scenario is a learning object, and as such, you need to start by defining the learning goal and the learning outcomes. The learning goal must be aligned with a true need, obviously, and the learning outcomes need to be defined as actions that learner will need to do. Then, to make your head around, you need to define the common mistakes that you want to correct with this training. So for this, you can consult FAQs or SMEs, subject matter experts, and find what's actually happening. Of course, defining the common mistakes goes along with the consequences. So an action leads to a reaction, and this needs to be clearly defined from the very beginning. So last, you may consider to use a basic template as a path and adjust it, or you may define your own. Let's see a bit some options for branching those scenarios. Designing branching scenarios involves constructing a story and creating branches for each possible decision that the learner could make. The typical concept of a branching scenario is the challenged with three choices and each choice leads into a consequence. And this is known as Tom Kilman's 3C model. And expanding this 3C model, we can have the simple mastery loop where mediocre and poor options return to the decision point, or the mastery loop with alternate endings where multiple repetitions of decisions are allowed. Another structure is the continuous story with a scored ending, where the mediocre and poor decisions allow learners to move on, and at the end, they will have the option for a poor, mediocre, and best ending. But despite this well-organized and clear path templates, depending on the learning goal of the instructor, and the branching options are endless. Here, for example, we can see a gamified approach. I call it all or nothing. Here, learners have the option to either successfully complete all the challenges, gain gifts from each challenge and move on, or they will be sent to Tartarus, as this lesson was made for Greek mythology, and as a game over. Of course, learners in this case could take the course, the lesson multiple times. Now, considering these different paths is a complicated process. And if you try to do it by heart, just jumping into Moodle site and add the lesson and start building it, it's pretty sure that you will get confused sooner or later. At the beginning, as Richard said, I used to draft them with also pencil and post-it notes, but I needed a real big board to put them. Then I started using drawing softwares like LibreOffice Draw or Google Drawing, and also some mind map tools that was also helpful, until just recently, I found Twine, which is an open source software. So, where to start from?
Just sorry, Anna, just to interrupt very quickly. There's just a question in the chat here from Alice. What does OSS mean?
Open source software. That's the acronym. Yep. Sorry. Being in the Moodle environment for a long time seems, yeah. I will fix it. Thank you. Starting with a lesson, where to start from? I would suggest to start with a quiz, because keeping it simple is indeed smart. And in our case, quiz means define the goal, the common mistakes, and the consequences. Let's move on to a real example. Some time ago, I was invited to offer a blended Moodle training to educators who were relatively new to Moodle. I thought that Moodle Academy is for them the right place to start with. But I didn't want to offer a presentation talking about Moodle Academy. That would be quite dull, and it was already, it would be a long, a very long training day. So I want something more engaging, more active. That's why I thought to create a branch lesson to guide learners through the Moodle Academy and let them self-explore. So I defined the learning outcome as following: create an account by the end of this learning object. Participants should create an account in Moodle Academy, should visit the main learning paths in Moodle Academy, and detect a course of their interest. Here, the consequences are not exactly consequences, but what I want to to achieve was to nudge these educators to create an account and explore the academy themselves and choose a course to take. So, time for a demo. From all the tools that I have tried for the development of, for the design of branching scenario, I found Twine the easiest one to use. As I said, it's open source, so it's free to download and use it. And literally, it took me just 5 minutes to find myself around. And for sure, I'm not considering myself an expert in its use, and you will see. With just the basics, I can do my work. So let's go for the demo. If you go to the link twinery.org, you will be redirected into this page for Twine. You can either download the desktop app or just use it in your browser. And I will just do that. So here, I'm starting a new story. I will call this story Explore Moodle Academy. And here it is. I have my rocket here and the first page. My intention is, first of all, to ask the learners if they have a Moodle Academy account. So this, the first page will be a question. Let me rename and give it name. If they have Moodle Academy account, and then I will put my question in it. Double clicking here and adding the question. So someone starts and the first thing they see is, have you created an account in Moodle Academy? This is the first thing I want to know. And the options are two, yes or no. If they answer yes, I want to redirect them to review the learning pathways. If they say no, I want to redirect them and tell them, go create your account and come back. So I will create a jump here simply by adding double brackets. If they say yes, they will be redirected into a page called Learning Pathways. And if they say no, they will be redirected into a page called Create an Account. As you can see, I have two pages here with their jumps, which is very, very convenient. Now, let me first finalize this Create an Account. If they haven't created an account, I want to tell them to make a stop, a pause here, and go to the Academy site, create their account, and retake the activity. So this is my message here. And if they choose this path, I want the lesson to end. So I'll put the end of lesson as well as a jump. Because they have to wrap up this activity and come back after a while. Now in the learning pathways, for those who have already searched a little bit and move around in the Academy site, there are three learning pathways, and I want them, oops, this is accidentally run too far. And I want them to review those paths and make a decision which one it's their preferred one. if I guess you are aware that Moodle Academy has three pathways, the educator, administrator, and the developer. And they will have to make a choice, learners. And by making this choice to choose one of these, I will need to take them into a question and ask them if they have detected a specific course from this pathway. So for each option, I'm going to create an extra question page. Let's see how it goes. So from the learning pathways, I have developer, educator, administrator. Let me put this in the order I'm usually think of them. And again, I need to fill in the gaps here, the content here. So for the educator page, I don't know why it's jumping that far. I can also click edit. For the educator pathway, I just want to give them a small introduction of what things exist, what kind of courses, and ask them if they have detected or selected a course or program to take already. If they say yes, then I'm going to ask them which one. If they say no, I'm gonna tell them to search further. So for the educator pathway, learning pathway, I have two options. Now, for the which one, I have this question page. I need to actually tell them the question, ask them which course or program you have selected to start with. And when they reply to me, I just want to tell them, go for it. And, you know, like support their decision. And the content that they will find this go for it page won't be something amazing. Just tell them to go for it. And then they should be directed to the end of lesson. So this ends here, but this is just one path. I have also, from the educator pathway, the dig further page. So I need to edit this one as well and tell them to search further for learning opportunities available in Moodle Academy and start their learning journey today. And again, I'm redirecting them to the end of lesson. So I've closed, you can see this here, or I can take it far away. I've closed both options, either going with yes or no. And I've closed the educator path. And I'll do the same for the administrator. I mean, I want to ask them, tell them what the administrator pathway has, the options, and ask them if they have selected a course or a program to take already? And again, if they say yes, I would like to redirect them to the which one page. And if they say no, I will redirect them to dig further. The pages where the which one and dig further were already set up. So basically, Twine has just added the links here. And the last one for the developer, it's exactly the same concept, a description of the pathway and the same question. And that's it. And now I have the three pathways with the two options, and all the options lead and end to the end of lesson. And this is my lesson. Do we have, Richard, any questions, anything from the chat about this tool?
A couple of comments so far. The Twine, I'm probably pronouncing your name wrong. I'm sorry about that. Tavia, you can even develop it since it's in a very simple standard language, HTML, CSS, and therefore it can be embedded into any page, something like a blog or similar. And you can also use it to create content and combine it with Moodle activities. So not only using it to plan, but actually using the output, using what you create and embedding that.
Indeed. But if you are familiar with CSS and all this stuff, which are,
yes, obviously,
difficult for me, it's not my expertise. So I'm really trying to keep things simple.
I mean, we touched on it as well earlier, but we did mention that the lesson can be quite complex. I think I mentioned the, planning out with pieces of paper and putting them everywhere. Just in your quick little demo there, you can see that it does, to be able to plan it properly up front before you actually get into starting building it is really going to be advantageous, which you are about to show us, Anna. So back to you.
Thank you. So let's see now, having built our scenario, how we can transfer it into Moodle. As all the activities in Moodle Lesson has also its own setting page. Depending on the purpose of your lesson, you have to tweak these settings accordingly. And let's just see here the most characteristic ones. Lesson has a progress bar to show how far a learner got. It can display a menu with a list, which is a list of contents, and this is good for accessibility reasons. It can show learners' ongoing score to show the progress as they go. It offers the option to try the question again if a question is answered wrongly. It allows learners to take once or multiple times the lesson. And of course, it has several activity completion and multiple options for automated auto completion. In our case, we want to build an interactive guide that will help learners get familiar with the Moodle Academy site. So we are just going to change very, very few things. Actually, we're going to add the name, the grade, and the set the completion. But we don't need something more than that. As I said, the main features that Lesson supports are the content pages that have content, of course, and jumps, the question page that contain options, feedback if necessary, scores and jumps, and the end of lesson, which is needed to close the attempt. And there are some other options like the cluster. It's a feature that allows teachers to set up a group of questions that will be randomly presented and answered by learners. And also there is an import question option for bulk uploading of questions that are written in specific format like ICANN, Moodle XML, etc. Again, my advice is to keep things simple and complete the development process this time in three steps. First, we will add a lesson activity. Then we will draft the lesson, adding all the content and question pages. And third, we will finalize the lesson by refining the jumps. So that's the question, the point here, and we are ready for another demo. I'm here in a Moodle course. This is a Moodle cloud site, but you know, all sites, all Moodle sites are basically the same. And what I want to do is to add a lesson. Now, this is the first step, adding the lesson. And the first thing I need to do is to define the name of the activity. And you can see there are multiple options here, multiple settings. As I said before, we don't need to go through this in big detail. There are specific guides and Moodle documentation that can help you with all these. What I want to set up is to allow the retakes, because I want learners to be able to take these multiple times. And also from the activity completion, I want to set this up to be manually completed when students receive a grade and reach the end of the lesson. And I'm moving on. So that was the first step, just adding the activity. Of course, you can always come back and change the settings of the activity. Now, here we can see that we have four options to import questions, but I don't have the questions ready to upload them in bulk, to be honest. We can add a content page, we can add a cluster, and we can add a simple question page. If you recall, our first page was a question page. So all I have to do, why this jumping? It's just copy-paste my stuff from here to the lesson. The first was a question page. I will add it as multi-choice because as true-false, I want to use yes and no, so I prefer that from adding a true-false. So I'm adding the title. Well, the title was actually if they have a Moodle account. And the first option is yes. The second option is no. I don't need to touch anything else at the moment. I'm just saving the pages. I'm in the second step. I will just add the content of the content pages and the question pages. And you can see here that we have the option, page has been inserted. Great. To see this as expanded or collapsed. If you click the expanded view, you will be accessing the score, the jumps and everything, all the details. To be honest, I prefer working with in collapsed mode. and it gives me a better overview of where I am. And I'm moving on to create the second page. It was a content page called Create an Account. And here, it was the nudge to create the account and come back. So I need to add a new page. I'm selecting content page. I'm just copying pasting here. Now I have a description here, which means that after the text, the learners will be seeing a button that they will click to go somewhere. If you see this page take us to the end of lesson. So I will add here, I will call here the button continue, or could be end of lesson. And I will set the jump end of lesson to the end of lesson and saving. So this first branch has been set up from the initial question to the first content page and to the end of the lesson. Now I'm coming to set up the second branch with the learning pathways. The learning pathways is also a content page. Just copy pasting here. And here I have three options. The educator pathway. You know, I'm copy pasting, so I have multiple things open. I just make sure that things are clear for you. So I've built this content page with three buttons that they should be leading to these three different pages. So I need to build each of these three pages. And if I remember, these are question pages. So I'm going for a question page. And again, because my options are yes or no, I still need a multi-choice page. And let me first set up the question about the educator pathway. So, have you selected a course in our program to take? Yes. And no is the other option. And saving the page. And I have the educator question, the administrator question, the developer question pages are basically the same. So here I can duplicate the educator page. And edit this one to set up the administrator one. Change the text inside that is different a little bit. And leaving the option as they are because they were the same. And repeat the process for the developer. So I have set up the three questions. If I go back, you can see here, I'm here, the three questions. And I have another question page. It's called the which one that I need to set up. This question is an open-ended question. So I will select essay. as you can imagine, essay type questions in lessons are everywhere else need manual assessment. And to be honest, I don't want to assess this one. So I will change the score from 1 to 0 and save the page. And I have 2 more pages to set up, the go for it. Okay, let me do this. Is a content page. Just to congratulate them. And it will lead to the end of the lesson. So I will add here continue, or I could add another descriptor and select the end of lesson in the jumps. For some reason, it feels easier to me to add only the end of lesson jumps during this process, but you can always do it later if you want to. And the last page, I'm missing this one, the dig further. And again, this page also leads to the end of lesson. So I will add here, continue as well. And also select the jump, my way to do things. Now, if we try to, we have now all these pages added, but if you try to take it, to preview it, you won't go far, you know, because the jumps are blocking you. You cannot really have the flow that you have designed. So we need to edit the lesson and review the jumps correctly. So the first question we have for the yes, people should be redirected to the learning pathway, and for the no, to create an account. So let's do this. Yes should take them to the learning pathways, and no should take them to create an account. You can see here easily the jumps. From the create an account, we go to the end of lesson, so we don't need to revisit this one. But from the learning pathways page, which is this one, each of the options should lead to the respective question. So from here, we need to edit. And when we have the educator description, we should go to the question educator. When we have the administrator, to the administrator question. And from the developer to the developer. As you can realize, if we don't create the pages and the questions, we cannot actually set the jumps. So that's why we need to build lessons in 3 steps. First, add the activity, then fill questions and content, and last, set the jumps. Now, from the educator pathway, from the educator question, we go to if the answer is yes, to which one? And if the answer is no, to the dig further. And the same for the administrator. Yes goes to which one? And no goes to dig further and saving. And this is how it goes. I won't finalize this. The process is repeatable. I think it's clear how the process. Jessica, do we have any questions at this point about this process?
We have a comment from Tabia about actually having three options for branching within Moodle. So at course level, you can force a path through controlling access to different activities. So for example, you can... The teacher can choose the teacher task, students can choose the student task, or you can control it through language, for example. At the activity level, with the lesson activity, which you've just demonstrated, or the H5P branching scenario, or within a lesson activity as a specific chapter with embedded H5P.
Oh, it's quite advanced, but it's a very interesting concept indeed. That's very interesting.
And another comment from Tabia is, if you have the multi-language add-on installed, these buttons and all the content can be multilingual except the chapter titles. So those must be in a single language or with numbers. So another good point.
That's another good point. And well, in Academy, we can also have the translations and lessons, as far as I remember, can also be translated with our translation plugin.
And we also have a question, which I think I've answered now in the chat, with a link to our docs, Moodle docs, about what a content page is, to learn more about that. So people have been able to read that directly. Mm-hmm. So just, asking what a content page was. So basically a page where a teacher can provide information to move the lesson forward, but without requiring the student to answer specific questions.
Perfect.
And Tabia is just asking now, what do you mean by translations?
Moodle Academy, in Moodle Academy, we have a plugin, it's called translation plugin, and that can help educators and pretty much everybody, because we are inviting community, to translate the content, not using the multilingual but using this plugin.
I'll post a link to that in the chat as well if anyone wants to have a look at it. There you go.
Thank you so much.
But that means you need to translate a whole course? Not necessarily. You could choose to translate part of it if you wanted to. That's up to you.
Yep. And the translation plugin works with the languages menu of the system. So if you change the language, you change, actually, you may be able to see the translated content. But anyway, we will see this at the end. I want to come back to this lesson and just go quickly through this, just to give, this is a preview, of course, editing mode. You can see the buttons, you can see the titles, how they appear. If I make selection here, you can see the options and so on. And how it looks. Now, And ask you, would you give Moodle Lesson now a try? Please let us know in the chat. Do you still think that the Moodle Lesson is jigsaw? Or how do you feel?
Sandra Jane says, yes, she would. We had a comment about the Twine is used to draft the workflow and it's used as a reference point then just to make the workflow clearer before mm-hmm. you start developing in Moodle, in the Moodle lesson. Lucy T says, totally. Ross says, yes, I will. Sophie, nice to have the demo with Twinery.
Just moving on, about to wrap up this session. Sorry for the extra time. I would like to share some tips about the lesson. My first tip is basically design the scenario. Design your scenario using an appropriate tool. I would recommend that, something that would make your life easier, something simple that won't take you a life to learn it. I used to, and it could be something else for you. That's fine, but use something to design. Start your story and build each path linear, taking it up to the end, choice by choice. You will have to repeat this process for every option, of course, but the concept is always the same. The mistake, the option, the consequence, the mistake, the option, the consequence, and so on until the end of lesson. The second tip is to use meaningful titles. You've seen how important and how easy it was to set up the jumps between the pages and options following just selecting the right title of the page. So both your questions and your content page should have meaningful titles. In this drop-down menu, you will see that the first jumps are relevant to the page you are currently editing. So it's next, previous, end of lesson, or random pages. And after the relevant jumps, you will be seeing the list of pages you have added in the order you have added them. Meaningful titles are essential for setting up accurately the jumps, especially if you want to take users to specific pages and follow a specific learning path. Do note that in question pages, the titles do not appear to learners, but the content, the titles in content page appears headings. So you can also have this in mind. The third tip is to use first the option for the correct answer. When filling up the lesson, make sure that the first answer is always the correct answer. Moodle Lesson by default shuffles the options. So especially if you have multiple choice questions, this will save you a lot of time. And as an editing teacher, my fourth and last tip is to use a real student account for testing the lesson. As an editing teacher, you can certainly go through the lesson to check its flow, but I would highly recommend that you use a true student account to see exactly what the students experience. I wouldn't even recommend to change your role to student in order to review a lesson. I always prefer a real student account to go through that. Otherwise, for example, progress bar, if enabled, won't be visible, is only visible to students, so you won't be able to see it. And some minor things, also aesthetics. Things might look a little bit different to you, because you may see warning messages or informations from the system, while students don't see these. And it's always good to check it with a real account.
A number of people are actually asking to see what it looks like for students, actually, Anna, in the chat. And while you do that, somebody asked before what theme you were using. It looks like the default Boost theme.
I will show you with the non-recommended login as, because the site, I don't have the credentials for student account at the moment. So here it is. It's quite simplified. You can see my grades, return and retake. This time I'll say yes. Great. Those theme things depend on what you have in your site. And I can keep taking it again and again. One thing that is not added in my tips, but I would highly recommend is to use some graphics. Not overdo it, but when you tell a story, you can use some characters or some icons. That also is very eye-catching. Consider it's interesting. It makes feel like a real life. It's like you are reading a magazine, something.
Vispanath had a quick question, whether you don't trust the change role feature. So when you said not to use change role just now.
Yes, well, I'm using lessons for ages. I mean, from the very beginning of Moodle back in, I don't know, 2005. And at for several years, I was having not accurate picture of what the student was seeing when I was changing the role. To be honest, in Moodle 4, what I see as student, the real student, and what I see as change role student is accurate, but I haven't searched it in all, searched it fully with clusters and random questions and stuff like that. So I'm still a bit reluctant from my previous experience from the older versions, actually. That's why I'm reluctant.
We also have someone asking if you can pop out the burger menu so we can see the contents for students.
Yes.
So on the left, I assume, as a student, if you keep as a student, Anna.
Oh, I haven't. Hold on. I haven't enabled that. So
yeah, he actually means the course menu on the left. So if you go back in as a student and then click on the left-hand course menu, not the right-hand block.
You mean?
That one, yes, the course index.
It's exactly the same. It doesn't change. But this is not what the lesson is not the progress bar or the menu of the lesson. Okay, this is the course. That's why I changed here my role, just to adjust the settings a little bit. And show you progress bar and the display menu. And also let me quickly add completion, activity completion, activity results. Yes.
Yeah. Claire was asking about the menu because when you use a book, you can navigate with that menu. So
of course,
in this case.
Of course. Sometimes when you actually provide learning content, I find very important to give this menu. But when you want to do it as a game, then you lose an element of surprise by providing the lesson menu. That's why I hadn't added it here in my settings. Now you can see that the lesson menu looks exactly like the table of contents from the book. And you can navigate directly to any page. And also the progress bar.
Someone also asked, Jay was asking that should the first yes, no question score be set to zero or left as is, i.e. one for yes and zero for no?
Yeah. Well, to be honest, I hadn't thought that deeply. I think you have a point setting that to no. But on the other hand, the completion criteria of the activity are said to require a grade and reach the end of lesson. So if your answer is no, the first question, you get 0 points and you have to come again because you won't have completed the activity. You have one more reason to come again back and retake it.
And there was also a comment about the name lesson being a bit confusing because really it's a branching activity rather than a lesson.
Yes. I have, when I was first starting building branching scenarios, I used to say, as titles, C1 for content page, C2 for the second content page, and Q1 for the content page, for the question page, and so on. And when it was time to set up the jumps, I couldn't remember what was C2 for, or Q3, what was for, what was the question. It was quite complicated. That's why I prefer to have descriptive titles so I can easily make choices. Do we have any other questions?
A comment from Tabia again to say, I like the lesson menu for inclusivity. Some learners get distracted or confused by only progressing in such an organic way. The menu helps to orient.
Yep, that's true.
And you can only skip the jumps if the programming allows it. So you can force that some content must be seen by choosing the way of how you progress from one chapter to the next. So that's a case for using the menu.
Definitely.
And Ms. Vanath wanted to ask, what is the 55 in the menu? What is the 55 menu?
55?
I didn't see that.
The percentage?
Oh, the percentage down the bottom?
It's completion progress, how much of the lesson I still have as a student. Not the score, because there is another bar for ongoing score and another bar for progress within the course. Have we covered the questions?
Yes, that's it. And people are dropping off now, so.
Yes, and I'm really sorry if this took us longer than I was planning to. So If you have enjoyed this session, we would love you to consider getting involved further and help us grow by contributing to the development of Moodle Academy. You can do this by visiting our Get Involved course, which you will find out in the front page of Moodle Academy site. You can suggest ideas for new webinars and courses, and you can also vote for ideas that have been suggested by others already. We are always out for looking up for community members to help us present webinars and co-create the short online courses. And of course, we would love for your help making Moodle Academy more inclusive. So if you are able so, please jump into our Translate Moodle Academy course and get started with helping us translate our courses and webinars into other languages. And of course, please help us spread the word about Moodle Academy by telling your colleagues about the courses we offer and the events we run. When you complete a course, you will earn a badge, and educators might like to think about getting involved with the Moodle Educator Certificate. There is a course called Are You Ready for the MEC? And there is a quiz that you can take and see if you are ready for this certificate. Thank you for joining us today. I hope you find this useful, and I hope to see you on the Moodle Academy course forums and our upcoming webinars.